Hey friends, it's Corey from Hey Let's Make Stuff. This is Illustrator tutorial number 8 in my series for SVG crafters and designers. Today we're diving back into text. I'm going to show you some fun text effects that you can use to make your SVGs more unique. This video builds off of the others in this series, so there will be things that I'm not fully explaining in this video because I have covered them in other videos. So if you haven't watched the other videos in this series, I highly recommend that you go back and watch those videos so you're not lost or confused while watching this video. As with every video, I highly recommend that you use keyboard shortcuts. I use them throughout the video, and you can also get a free keyboard shortcut printable with all the keyboard shortcuts that I recommend for SVG designers and crafters, and nothing you don't need. If you're ready to get started, let's dive into Illustrator. First, we're going to talk about making text in an arc. Now, this arc text effect is similar to typing on a circle, which we talked about in one of the earlier lessons, but this is a faster way to do it. It doesn't always work because as you adjust the arc, it does warp your text a little bit, whereas typing on a circle does not. But I find that this is actually an easier way to kind of create that arc. But sometimes I do need to move to that circle technique that we talked about earlier, just because maybe a particular font doesn't look really great with this arc. So I kind of go back and forth between typing on a circle or using this arc tool. Let's say I have this little chick image. You should be able to make something very similar with what we've learned in previous lessons. So you can see here that most of this is just shapes. I've got a circle for his head and his eyes, a little triangle for his nose. I used lines here, including a dashed line for these Easter egg effects. And then I drew this Easter egg using the pen tool, as well as the little feathers on his head, which I then united with his head to make it one piece. So you should be able to draw something similar. And if you'd like to try, I would say go ahead. This is a really great practice image for you to try and recreate. Now let's say I want to add just hatched above. This would be really great for, you know, a baby bodysuit and other sort of newborn gifts. And I want just hatched to sort of arc over the chick's head. I'm going to click on just hatched using the select tool, which is V. And then I'm going to go up to the menu at the top and I'm going to go to effect, warp, arc. Now this will arc your text. Now you can see here that if you have the preview button checked, it will actually show you your arc as you change it. So if I increase my arc here, you can see it increased here above my chick. Now I mentioned before that it can distort your text, so I'm going to really increase it here. If you want more of like a half circle like this, I would use the type on a circle technique that we used in the other lesson. But if you want just a subtle arc, something more like this, then you can definitely use this arc. You can also bend it in a negative way so that it goes underneath, which is really great. I use that quite a bit. You can also distort this horizontally and vertically. I don't do this very often, but it does come in handy every once in a while. Say you needed to fit your text in a certain type of shape, you can use this to sort of fit it into a shape. I don't use it a lot, but it can be handy. Once you're happy, you can click OK. Now you can see here when I hover over it, you can see the original text here on its original line. To make this cuttable on a cutting machine, I'm going to make sure I have it selected. Again, the select tool is V. Then I'm going to go up to Object, Expand Appearance. Now you can see that each letter is outlined in blue, and this is an actual cutting piece. Now I'm going to make it a compound path, which is Command 8 if you're on a Mac, Control 8 if you're on a PC. And that will just make just hatched cut all in one piece. I'm gonna move it down here just a little bit below our chicken, try and center it. Perfect. Now, if I go over here to the layers panel and I open up the layers panel, you can see that this first compound path is just hatched. And then I do have my chick grouped. So all of his little compound path parts are underneath. To group something, just select all the pieces you'd like to group and then use Command G if you're on a Mac, Control G if you're on a PC, and that will group those pieces together. I think this little chick is ready to be cut. Next up, we are going to use the offset tool. So this is similar to using the offset tool in something like Cricut Design Space, but there are some things you need to know, so let's go through them. To start, I feel like my little XOXO for Valentine's Day here is a little boring, and we talked about this in one of the other lessons. If you have the text tool selected, which is going to be T, and then you click in to your font, down below you will see all the alternate characters for each letter. So for this one, I'm going to add a little swoosh over the top, and then for the other X, I'm going to add a swoosh underneath. Already so much better. Now let's select our text using the select tool V. And I'm going to outline my fonts. The shortcut for that is Shift-Command-O if you're on a Mac, Shift-Control-O if you're on a PC. And now our font has been turned into cuttable shapes. Right away, I'm going to make this a compound path. So I'm going to choose Command-8 or Control-8. And this is another one of those examples where you think that maybe your artwork has disappeared. If I click off of it, You can't see it at all. But basically, by making it a compound path, sometimes it turns it into having an empty fill. So all you need to do is go back and add a fill, just like that. Now we can use the offset tool. I'm going to go up to Object, Path, Offset Path. And if you have the preview checked, you can actually see what your offset will look like. Now for this one, I want to add quite a larger offset, maybe 0.3. And generally I use round joins, which means you're gonna have round corners. You can also miter your corners. They actually don't look so bad on this font. They look really bad on some other fonts, but generally I kind of stick to this round offset. Then I'm going to click okay. And now you can see here when I hover over it, I can select my text or I can select the offset piece. In this offset piece, I don't love these white triangle sort of pieces we have in our gaps. So I'm going to double click on the offset piece. This takes it into an isolation mode, and then you can click on these individual pieces and delete them. I'm just using the delete or backspace key, and you can just walk right in there and delete them. To get out of the isolation mode, just double click onto your artboard. Now you can see here that I still have my original XOXO, and then I have this offset with no holes in it. So I'm going to change the color of my XOXO to white. I'm gonna open up my little palette here, and I'm going to choose white. And then for the background, I'm going to choose like a dark pink. Right away, this is super cute, but you can add another offset to it. So I'm going to select that offset using V. Then I'm going to go to Object, Path, Offset Path. And that gives me a second offset. I'm going to keep it the same, click OK. And then with the second offset, I'm going to make it light pink. Now I want to click each piece and make it a compound path, Command 8 or Control 8. Just like this. And then when I open up my layers panel, you can see that I have my single layer with my three compound paths. This XOXO file is ready to cut and it's perfect for Valentine's Day. Now let's make one of those retro wavy designs. So I've got Good Vibes Only typed here in my favorite retro font, Nelly. I will link all of the fonts I'm using down in the description below. So I type this out using the text tool, T. If you remember back to the font tips lesson, I don't often use a text box with more than one line, but for this particular design, I need to. So I have a single text box here and I hit enter after every line. And then I realized, you know what? Actually, maybe I want capital letters. There's an easy little trick to changing all of your letters to all caps. Go to type up in the menu bar, go to change case, and here you can change it to uppercase. You can also change uppercase letters to lowercase. You can use title case or even sentence case. But I generally go between uppercase and lowercase. So I'm going to choose uppercase, and it automatically changes everything to uppercase, meaning that I don't need to retype it with the caps lock on. Now we need to make each line the same size. This just looks best for this type of design. So I'm going to click in here and get my text tool. I'm going to select just the word good, and then I'm going to increase the font size until it lines up with Vibes. So I can do that up here in this font dropdown. I can type in a different number. I can use these little stepper arrows. I can also do that over here in the character panel underneath properties. I'll go ahead and do it over here. And I'm just gonna step it up until it's about the same size, just like that. I'm gonna do the same thing with only, step it up here. So it's about the same size. Now the line spacing, which is also called leading in Illustrator, is too tall here. So I also want to decrease the leading. So to start, I'm going to click on Vibes, and this is going to affect the line spacing above the word I have selected. So I'm going to go over here to the character panel, and I'm going to decrease that letter spacing or leading. So I'm just going to use the stepper arrow, and that will move it closer to the word good. Just like that. Now I'm going to select the word only, and I'm going to do the same thing, decreasing the leading so that it's closer to Vibes. This is looking pretty good to me. All of the lines are the same width, and we have about the same amount of spacing between our lines. Move it down here to the center of my artboard, and then I'm going to apply the wave effect. So I'm going to go up to Effect, Warp, and Wave. Now, I should have mentioned earlier that there are other things you can do to your text underneath here other than arc and wave. I tend to use arc and wave the most. I use rise a little bit, but the others I don't use very often. Again, if you have the preview button checked, you can see your changes live. So I can make my bend really, really high and it becomes almost unreadable. I can also make it go the other way, which works too. But really, you just want sort of a groovy little wave. You don't want too much or too little. You want to make it still readable, still cuttable. Once you have a number you're happy with, click OK. Now we can outline our text. That's Shift Command O or Shift Control O. And sort of like with our first example of just hatched, you can see where the original image was, but it's been sort of warped. So we need to go up to Object, Expand Appearance. And that actually gives us the shapes that we want here. Now, if we want to make each line a separate color, we have to ungroup everything. So that's Shift Command G on a Mac or Shift Control G on a PC. And that ungroups everything. So let's go ahead and make each of these lines a different color. Make good pink, vibes teal, and only yellow. Then we can make each of these lines a compound path, meaning that they will cut together on your cutting machine. So I'm going to use that Command or Control 8 to make each of these lines a compound path. I'm just dragging to select, just like that. And if I open up my layers panel, you can see that I have a single layer with three compound paths underneath. For this final example, we're going to make sort of a retro 3D shadow. I feel like these are the sort of files that you would find maybe on like retro vintage baseball uniforms, those sorts of things. So you want to choose kind of a chunky retro script font for this particular tutorial. Right now I have Selfia, which is one of the fonts I use quite a bit. It works really well for this type of design. Once you have your word typed using that text tool, the keyboard shortcut is T, we are going to start off by outlining our font. That is Shift Command O or Shift Control O. And now you can see, because we have our overlapping letters here, we need to actually unite this into a single shape, or it's going to cut over each letter. So I'm going to go over to that Pathfinder panel. If you don't see the Pathfinder panel, you can go up to Window, Pathfinder. And I'm going to have my image selected using the keyboard shortcut V. And I'm going to unite, which is the top left option here. This gives us one single shape. Now we also want to make this a compound path, so Command 8 or Control 8. And now we have our word, and we're going to actually use that offset path again to start. So I'm going to have my word selected, and I'm going to go to Object, Path, Offset Path. Now I have quite a large offset because of the last one that we did, but I'm going to make this one actually much smaller. Let's try 0.1. And I don't mind that this one has some gaps. I think that's going to be fine. I'm going to click OK. Now, again, you can see the original color and you can see the offset. Right now, I'm going to go ahead and change the colors of these things. I'm going to make the inside one white and I'm going to make the outside one teal, just like that. Now, I'm going to select the offset and I'm going to copy and paste it. So that's Command C or Control C to copy, Command V or Control V to paste. So I'm going to copy and paste it. So I want to put this sort of below and to the right of the current word that I have there. This is what's going to create that 3D look. So right now we have it in the front and we need to send it to the back. So you can go up here to Object, Arrange, Send to Back, or you can use the keyboard shortcut Shift, Command, or Control, and then the open bracket, and that will send it to the back. Now this would be sort of a typical drop shadow. You could even change this back color. Let's say we changed it to black and it would look very much like a regular drop shadow. But I'm going to keep it teal here. And basically I want to connect this first offset to the back offset to create that sort of 3D look. So I'm going to select the back offset and this top offset, but not the word wanderer. And then I'm going to go up to Object, Blend, Make. Now, I don't know if you noticed when I made that blend, we now have sort of a little bumpy area here. It's getting closer to looking right, but it's not quite there. We don't want these bumps sort of at the top of our D and our R over here at the end of the R. So I'm going to select the blend that I made. It actually selects all of the pieces at one time. Then I'm going to go to Object, Blend, Blend Options. Here we can change what our blend is doing. So right now we have smooth color, but I want to change it to specified steps. And I want to change it to 10. And it's a little hard to see because of the way that each of these letters is outlined, but I'm going to click OK, and then I'm going to click off of it. And you can see here now that I have a very smooth 3D look to my artwork here. Instead of having sort of a bumpy time on this top of this D, it's now super smooth and it has that sort of 3D effect. Now all we need to do is get it ready to cut. So I'm going to actually select that blend. I'm going to go to Object, Expand. And I'm going to make sure I have both Object and Fill selected, and I'm going to click OK. Now, what this does is it expands all of those steps that we made before. So there's basically 10 offsets sort of hidden behind the word wanderer. And that creates this sort of 3D look. Now, of course, we can't cut this because all of those would cut individually and it would be a disaster. So I want to make sure that I have that back selected. And then I'm going to go back to that Pathfinder tool. Remember, you can find that window Pathfinder if you don't have it, and click that Unite button, and that will make it all one shape. Now, if I choose my direct selection tool, which is A, you'll see that I have probably too many anchor points here. It'll probably cut okay, but honestly, this is just not great SVG design. So I do want to go up to Object, Path, and go back to Simplify. We've used this a couple times in other lessons, and this will just give you way fewer anchor points. So you can figure out where it actually looks good. You don't want all of those anchor points, but you do want it to retain its shape. So you can play around with this slider until you have something you like. Now, if I go here to these three dots, you can see once again that my original image had 302 points, and the new image only has 56, much more cuttable. Now, all we have to do is make each piece a compound path. So I'm going to select this back piece and I'm going to make it a compound path, Command or Control 8. And I'm going to select Wanderer again. I think it's already a compound path, but I'm going to make it again just in case. And then when I go to my layers panel, you can see I have my single layer and my two compound paths. I hope you enjoyed those four text effects. There are ones I use a lot and they're actually really easy to do once you get the process and the rhythm of actually making them. If you'd like a little homework this week, you can go back and try and recreate those four text effects in Illustrator. You could also try and recreate that chick from the first text effect using shapes, lines, and the pen tool. If you have any questions about using these tools in Illustrator, please let me know in the comments. For more videos on using Illustrator, your Cricut, sublimation printer, laser, and all sorts of other crafty content, follow my channel. I'll see you next week.